Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Shalom. thank you. Last year I had a very good presentation here, and maybe that was my best presentation ever. So that's why I came back to make a very short entertainment here on this stage to make you smiling and happy when I'm talking about very bad things. Well, I like travel. I was in many different parts of this world. I was on the South Pole, I was in New Zealand, I was in Northern South America, I was everywhere. And I'm just back from the expedition to the cyber hell. Well, exciting trip. I learned a lot. And I want to present you the result of this research, of this expedition. And actually, this is the first time I'm presenting this data to public. Why in Israel, it's just coincidence, nothing special. Cyber hell speaks many languages. Mostly Chinese. All dialects of Chinese. Spanish and Portuguese. Russian, Ukrainian, Turkish, Hebrew as well. Not so much, but yeah. It does. So, the result of this research is seven cycles of cyber inferno. Who the people are in a cyber hell? Who they are, why, and which cycles I saw in a cyber hell? The first is not too serious. The first cycle is full of researchers. They were innovators. They were inventors of malicious programs. People who were writing viruses in the 80s, 30 years ago, first to develop self-replicating viruses. Do you remember such names like a brain virus, which infected floppy disks? Maybe not. So actually these research viruses, they were just for to infect disk files to prove the concept of the self-replicating programs. And that was easy to kill the viruses, just to format the floppy disk. Do you still remember floppy disks? Do you remember the black square like this? I still have the 8-inch floppy in my office, yes. That's simple. Welcome to the next circle. Hooligans, vandals, which were writing viruses in the 90s. They did it just for fun, to display some funny messages or destroy the data or just do nothing, just for fun. Or just to be proud that, okay, my super virus is described in the virus encyclopedia. And actually that was the beginning of the antivirus industry to fight with this malicious code. We need just antivirus. That was the beginning of the story, it was primitive. Welcome to the third circle. Criminals. I call it C2C. Criminals to consumers. B2C, business to consumers. B2B, business to business. C2C, criminals to consumers. They were following money, and the internet development in the end of 90s, beginning of 2000, just the first time in the end of 90s and beginning of 2000, there's such a services introduced like internet money, online banking, and many others. So criminals, they were following. And the internet services, they were victims of these attacks. And to kill, to fight with cybercrime attacks, internet security suites, it's good enough. Well, of course, plus to cyber police forces in the nations, plus Interpol, which is opening office in Singapore next year. I'm pretty sure with the help of Interpol, there will be more people, not just in a third circle of hell, but also in prisons everywhere around the globe. We are supporting Interpol, we are partners of Interpol, and we will provide our knowledge and expertise to the Interpol office in Singapore, and we will do our best to keep, to control population of cybercrime. So there are three circles of cyber inferno. Welcome to circle number four. Hacktivists. They are worse than criminals. Because criminals, they want just your money, nothing more. Hacktivists, they want to damage your reputation or kill your business. There are many stories. I don't want to name all of them, maybe just a few. How many times Sony Corporation was hacked 3 years ago? Nobody knows. Many. Hacktivists were behind that. WikiLeaks is also full of the reports from the hacktivist groups. And to fight with hacktivists, actually, I think it's enough to have some extra endpoint security solutions, which is based not only on the traditional technologies, but on the whitelist technologies, when their applications, suspicious applications, they are simply not allowed to be executed. The applications which are not registered in the system, they're not allowed to be run in a protected environment. Welcome to the circle number five. Who is there? Espionage. Who are the people behind the espionage attacks, like Red October, Flame Gauss, it's a different story, but espionage as well. Who they are? Well, I don't have any hard data. I can't prove that, but I'm pretty sure there are many different groups of people are behind espionage attacks. Independent criminals, which are just by chance got access to the classified data, and they want to trade this data, and maybe governments or enterprises are customers. Criminals which are contracted by governments, or maybe criminals which were arrested and they had an option. Prison or service. That's why many espionage attacks, they look like criminal attack, because it's the same people doing almost the same job, but having a different customers. And states. Well, I don't have any hard data to prove that there are states behind espionage attacks, but I will be very, very, very surprised if it's not truth. I am pretty sure there are some people which know truth better than I do. My job is to protect my customers. Okay, and to protect the customers again, there is a need of the extra endpoint solutions, administration tools to make their IT design, to make their architecture of the organization in a more safe and secure way. Cut unnecessary connection to the internet, to monitor which data is traveling to and out, and ideas which I'm afraid I don't have enough of time to explain all of them. Education, and by education I mean to explain what the social engineering is to employees of the organizations. Actually, we have such a classes. We just have there about 40, 45 minutes presentation and examples of social engineering attacks. After this presentation, employees, they are paranoid. And it's much more difficult to infect organization where employees had such a training. Or maybe next time I'll come with that presentation. It's much more funny. Okay, so, and the next circle, the six circle. Military attacks, nation against nation. I understand that there are different point of views on this issue. There are different ways of definition of cyber weapons. But I believe that cyber weapons and cyber military attacks, it's the worst innovation of this century. Simply because cyber weapons, that's a malicious code. It can travel, it can infect innocent computers. It's a boomerang. How many computers were infected by Stuxnet in Israel and United States? Who knows? Well, many. So cyber weapons, that's a boomerang. Cyber weapon, it's very easy to learn. So these guys who are behind the attacks, they are in the cyber hell because they are teachers for the very bad guys. And the very bad guys, they take the place in the seventh circle of cyber inferno. Terrorists, cyber terrorists, guerrillas. I'm afraid that in the future we will see more and more attacks which we will define as cyber terrorist attacks. Attacks against nations, regions, or attacks against global infrastructure. Unfortunately, our world is very, very vulnerable. We depend on cyber systems. SCADA, PLCs, it's everywhere. We can't live without telecommunications. We can't live without the technologies. Unfortunately, the reality is we depend on IT. And the systems are vulnerable. And I'm afraid there will be more and more terrorists interested in attacking. And they are learning. And I count three major attacks, which I can call terrorist attacks. Attack on Estonia in 2007. Attack on Saudi Aramco last year, in August last year. And attack on South Korea bank systems this year. I'm afraid that we will see more and more attacks. And actually, that's why I think that cyber weapons, it's the worst innovation of this century. Because these guys, they learn from military attacks. They learn from espionage attacks. So I think that the best way to protect the cyberspace is not only technologies, not only national regulation, but also strong international cooperation between states to make this world more safe and more secure. I wanted to be very short because I know that we are out of time. So my presentation is over. Hell, even the cyber hell, is not the best place to stay. So welcome back to Tel Aviv. And people who are responsible for the cyber attacks, which are listed, stay in hell. Stay in Gehenom. Thank you.